To solve equations using the balance method, you need to unwrap the target variable one step at a time using inverse operations. And the balance part is that whatever you do on one side of the equal sign, you also have to do on the other. You have to keep the equation in balance by doing the same operation on both sides each step. The key to getting the balance method right is good setting out. You must be very careful to set things out neatly and correctly. Then you won't go wrong, and even if you do, it'll be very easy to find and correct your mistake. Always work down the page. Work vertically, not horizontally. Always keep equal things underneath each other. And always line up your equal signs directly underneath each other, down the page. Always work down, not across. Let's have a go. Solve x minus 67 equals 11. Now, yes, I know this is a very simple equation, and you can probably just guess the answer by inspection. But I want to use it to show you how the setting out works, down the page, keeping equal things underneath each other. And remember to make sure your x looks like a letter, not a time sign. Start by writing the equation out with plenty of space between the left-hand side and the equal sign. Don't be afraid of putting in extra white space. It will help you to keep things lined up and see clearly what you're doing. I recommend putting the equal sign about a third to a half of the way across the page, at least to begin with, until you get used to knowing how much room to leave for different kinds of equations. Okay, let's solve this equation using the balance method. We have to unwrap the variable x by doing inverse operations. Well, the only operation here is a subtraction, minus 67. The inverse of that is to add 67. So let's add 67 to both sides. Remember, you have to keep it balanced. If I add 67 to the left-hand side, to cancel out the minus 67, then I also have to add it to the right-hand side. 11 plus 67 is 78, so x must equal 78. Notice the way all the equal signs are lined up vertically, one under another, and the way I've written things that are the same as on the line above, directly underneath. That's important. It helps you to keep things organized and to find your mistakes, if you make any. Let's try the next one. Solve 3p minus 6 equals 84. First, write the equation out, with plenty of space around it. Again, put the equal sign some distance over, so you have room to write the steps in where you need to. Now, I have to unwrap that variable, p. If I was working forwards, substituting a value in for p, I would first be multiplying by 3 and then subtracting the 6. So to go backwards, to unwrap the p layer by layer, I have to unwrap the minus 6 first before unwrapping the times 3. So, first, undo the minus 6 by adding 6 to both sides. Keep it balanced by doing the same thing on both sides. That leaves me with 3p on the left and 84 plus 6, which is 90, on the right. Now, undo the 3 times p by doing the inverse operation. Divide by 3 on both sides. Take two lines to write your fractions neatly and vertically, or you can use a divide sign instead if you prefer. P equals 30. I can check my answer by going back to the original equation and substituting in my answer wherever I see a P. 3 times 30 is 90, minus 6 is 84. Good. When you get better at this, you may be tempted to skip a few steps. You can do that, but realize it will make it harder to find your mistakes. and it also means you're not communicating as well exactly what you're doing at each step. Please, don't just write the plus 6 and divide by 3 on the same line. Some people even write it really small on the outside of both sides. Both of these methods lead to other problems later on, when the equations you're solving are not this simple. Always write out a new line for a new step, and always write proper mathematical notation on every line. I'll show you what I tend to write as an experienced mathematician. You see, I'm still writing the same number of steps, but I'm not writing as much as the full working I had before. But it's still clear at each step what I'm doing to work my way towards the solution. Add 6, then divide by 3. This way of setting it out turns the balancing into almost more of a transfer from one side to the other. You just have to remember to always do the inverse operation when you transfer it to the other side. I recommend you stick with the full setting out first, and only consider writing less than this when you feel absolutely confident that you know what you're doing. Next one. 5 plus 4y equals 37. So write it out with plenty of space around it. We have to unwrap the variable, y, by doing inverse operations in the opposite order to normal. But don't be confused by the order in which it's written. Normally, I'd be doing the times by 4 first, and then adding the 5. So I'm going to have to subtract 5 first, and only then divide by 4. Subtract 5 from both sides. 4y equals 32. Note it's important to subtract 5. You can't just write 5 minus on the front. You have to think through the operations and the order they're being done, and you have to do the same thing to both sides. You want to subtract 5 because that will cancel out the 5 at the front. 5 minus 5 is 0. Now divide by 4 to get y equals 8. And check your answer by substituting it back into the original equation. 5 plus 4 times 8 is 5 plus 32, which is 37. Good. What if the expression is a bit more complicated? Here's one with some brackets in it. The process is exactly the same, just think carefully about what order to use to unwrap the variable. In this equation, normally I would do the brackets first and then the times by 6 out the front. So to go backwards to get to the variable, I have to divide by 6 first, which gives me a plus 9 equals 12, and then undo the plus 9 from inside the brackets. A equals 3. Again, check the answer by substituting it back into the original equation. Careful, do the brackets first. 3 plus 9 is 12, and 6 times 12 is 72. Final example, r over 6 minus 5 equals 3. Well, normally I'd do the divide by 6 first, then the minus 5. So let's unwrap it by adding 5 first. R over 6 equals 8. Now times by 6 to cancel the divide. R must equal 48. Check the answer. 48 over 6 is 8, minus 5 is 3.